Later, maybe. What sort of creatures are they? And just look at the cave.
I don't fucking know. I've never seen anything like this before either.
I don't like this.
What's up, sis? You scared? Come on, we're the children of Captain Steelbeard. The greatest pirate captain of all time. Father would never pass on something like this, and neither will we. There's something strange here. Let's explore.
Be careful. We don't know what's ahead.
Command, after all.
No, don't talk such crap. I'll get you out of here.
It's too late.
No. No. Goodbye.
Wamba, Kachoka, Rick!
What the hell?
Easy! You're not
Ready, yet take your time.
What?
Have patience.
What happened?
One thing at a time. After death, it takes time for your mind to clear. Believe me, I know what I'm talking about. My spirit was trapped in the underworld once, too.
What do you mean, you two?
Fine. Then tell me what you were doing buried. Having a little nap.
Look, I was...
And where is your companion? You didn't come here on your own, did you?
Hattie.
Yes, exactly. She buried you and has long since gone. But from now on, I'm going to keep a beady eye on you so you don't lose the rest of yourself.
What did the shadows do to me?
They killed you and took your spirit to the underworld. You're just a spiritless empty shell. It's only a matter of time before you become nothing but a soulless minion of the underworld.
Why me?
No idea, but someone in the underworld doesn't like you. Wrong place, wrong time, perhaps.
Me? A minion of the underworld?
Yes, my friend, you will become a demon, a lackey of the underworld. It will be a long and painful existence that'll end in damnation.
Well, that cheers me up.
Oh, there's no time for that. You need to find your spirit fast if you don't want to succumb. You are weakened and have forgotten much. You need a powerful mage. Two would be even better. Living without a spirit is no easy thing. Believe me.
How do we get away from here?
I've a sloop at anchor in the bay. It's no battleship, but fares well enough.
I want to look around.
Do what you must, but don't forget you've no spirit. If you don't want to mutate into some demon, you'd better pull your finger out. If you have any more questions, I'm right by your side.
Let's set sail.
The rowing boat'll get us to the sloop dry.
And where to now? Maybe I should ask Bones first. Where can I find them?
There are powerful sorcerers on the southern seas. Some of them are spiritual leaders of communities. But make sure you find yourself a strong one. They will help you regain your spirit.
Where are the exiled mages?
As far as I know, they've settled on the Thunder Isle of Tyrannis. They're digging up the island of gnomes, searching for small magic crystals. And only the mages know what they'll be used for.
The natives are powerful voodoo sorcerers.
That's true. The tribe that you should find most interesting lives on the island of Keela. Strong warriors, mighty shaman, pretty powerful voodoo. I should think you'll find what you're looking for there.
I need a druid now.
I heard of one on Kalador. I think the druid is called Eldric. He's supposed to be the spiritual leader of the demon hunters. They are extremely powerful dark warriors with their own kind of black magic. I'm sure they'd help you.
What about the Inquisition?
They lost their supremacy on the southern seas long ago. But the sugarcane plantation on Takarigua may still be there. I'm not sure the Bluecoats can help you, but who knows? I think you have enough information to find a powerful sorcerer now. You must decide where you want to go for help.
Come on, let's go.
Of course! And Alvarez wants to see you.
Ghost ships. I've seen something like them before, but that was a dream.
No, 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 this is no dream. It's Crow. Pirate Captain Crow.
That cutthroat. But he's fucking dead.
He's returned from the underworld and he's boarding every ship he comes across with his cursed fleet and minions.
Underworld?
We've got to get away. If they find us, we're done for.
Thank you.
you learned now, Gucho? Ono Bambule. And now, Gucho?
Shitty weather, shitty food, shitty natives. What are you doing here, stalking through the undergrowth? The natives are pissed off, so don't piss in their sink. As long as they don't give us water, you better scram. Ah, you're just talking crap. Why so quiet?
Mandaru is assessing you with his eyes. They will tell everything he needs to know.
And what did they tell you?
You are not one of the people from the shore. No, you are looking for something, and a long journey weighs heavy on your shoulders.
You've got to teach me that trick.
There is nothing to teach. Have you never looked at your own reflection in the water? Take a close look at it. It can tell you many things without saying a word. In your eyes, I see your search, while the clothes on your body tell me who you are. We Tufas learn that inner peace and observation are the keys to wisdom.
How come you know our language so well?
Mandaru has met many travelers and sought words of friendship with Guchos. But everything is different this time. The Guchos on the beach are at strife. I see discord. I see that words waste time. I see that nothing is as it was.
I don't think the pirates pose any threat to you.
You don't have the look of the hunter. Even the smallest animal will defend itself if it feels threatened. We Keela may be superior, but we will still suffer pain. If nothing happens, Mandaru fears that Gaia will be soaked in blood.
Tell me more about the tasks of a Tufa.
We Tufas take from nature what she gives us, but never too much. Only what we need. And then only when it's destined for us. If a Tufa is unable to slay his prey, he leaves, because the time hasn't come.
Thank you. Uwamba. Shit! My head.